মাইকেল নগর শিক্ষানিকেতন হায়ার সেকেন্ডারি গভর্নমেন্ট স্পন্সার্ড কোভিড ইংলিশ মিডিয়াম স্কুল হ্যাজ টেকেন অ্যান এক্সেলেন্ট ইনিশিয়েটিভ অফ টিচিং অ্যান্ড মেক আওয়ার স্টুডেন্টস লার্ন ডে টু ডে লেসন্স থ্রু অডিও অ্যান্ড ভিডিও ইন আওয়ার ইউটিউব চ্যানেল Teachers of all the subjects are working hard to enhance this online classes in amidst of this pandemic situation. It is a request to all the teachers, students and guardians to click the bell icon and subscribe our channel.
Everyone, today I am going to discuss the chapter current electricity of class 10. What is electricity? Electricity by practical means an amount of energy that can be converted into any type of desired energy. Suppose you are using calling bell, so electric energy is transferred into sound energy. You are using electric cooker, so electric energy is transferred into heat energy. So what are the components of this electricity? We will discuss about this. Let's start with electric charge. What are charges? Electric charges? When two substances are rubbed against each other, electric charges are formed. Suppose rubber and silk. When rubbed each other, electric charges are formed. There are two types of electric charges, that is positive charges or proton and negative charges or electrons. So when electrons are moving through a conductor, you know what is conductor? The conductor is the material in which electricity can pass. So, continuous drift of electrons through a conductor generates current or electricity. So, charges can be represented by the term Q. Charges can be represented by the symbol Q. And SI unit of charge is, SI unit of this charge is coulomb. SI unit of charge is coulomb. So, what is coulomb? When 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 number of electrons. So, this is a huge number of, these are the huge number of electrons. When passing through a conductor, there are total number of charges is 1 coulomb. So, charges of these number of electrons is 1 coulomb. So, what is charge of 1 electron? Charge of 1 electron is 1 by 6.25 into 10 to the power 18, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Is the charge of one electron. So, electron is mainly responsible for the constitution of current in a conductor. Okay. Starting Coulomb's law. What is Coulomb's law? When two similar charges or two opposite charges are kept in each kept in a distance of this R meter. Suppose this charge is Q1 and this charge is Q2. As we know that two opposite charge attract each other. And two same charges repel each other. So, when these two same charges are kept in a distance of R meter, what happens? According to Coulomb's law, we know there will be repulsive force, right? Two same charges are there, so there will be repulsion. So, what is the force of repulsion? This can be calculated with the help of Coulomb's law. So, according to Coulomb's law, the force of attraction or repulsion between two point charges is proportional to the product of magnitudes of charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two. Suppose the repulsive force, there is Q1, one charge is Q1, another charge is Q2 and they are kept in a distance of R meter. So, the repulsive force is F. This F, what is written here? This F is proportional to the product of magnitude. So, F varies Q1, Q2. Q1, Q2 is the product of two charges. So, F varies Q1, Q2. And the second thing, this force is inversely proportional to the square of distance. Distance means R. So, square of distance is inversely proportional. So, F varies 1 by R square. Combining both, we can write F varies Q1, Q2 by R square. So, F is equal to K into Q1, Q2 by R square. As we are removing this proportional sign, we are writing here a constant that is known as electrostatic force constant. Electrostatic force constant. So now in vacuum this k have a particular value, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. K is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q1 q2 by r square. This is the mathematical form of Coulomb's law. So when two charges, similar charges are kept, there will be repulsive force, and this force can be calculated by this formula, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q1 q2 by r square. Similarly, if there are two opposite charges, there will be attractive force. The formula is same, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q1 q2 by r square. Here the those charges are positive, so the answer will be positive. If one of them is negative, the answer will be not negative. We are only calculating the mod value, so answer will always positive. And 1 by 1, what is the value of epsilon 0? Epsilon 0 is the permittivity of the medium, permittivity of the medium in which the charges are kept. So in vacuum, we can calculate the value of this epsilon. Epsilon 0 has a particular value in vacuum, that is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 Coulomb square Newton inverse meter to the power minus 2. You should know the value of this, so you have to learn the value only. What is the value of epsilon 0 in vacuum? You have to learn this value. Suppose this Q1 and Q2 have a definite value. Suppose this Q1 is and Q2 is 1 Coulomb. Q1 is equal to Q2 have a definite value, that is 1 Coulomb of charge. And R is also have a definite value, R is 1 meter. So then this value can be calculated. F will be what? 1 by 4 into pi. Pi means 3.14. So 4 into 3.14, 4 pi epsilon 0. Putting the value of epsilon 0, that is 8.854 into 10 to the power 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and this is only 1, q1, q2 is 1, r is 1. So by calculating these, we will get this number. So when F is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton, that means when two similar charges are kept in vacuum of 1 Coulomb. 1 Coulomb is the charges that are kept in a distance of 1 meter. Then the value repulsive force is 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton. Okay, so now we will know what is the direction of flow of current. Suppose there are two balls A and B. The heat energy, amount of heat energy contained in A ball, that is 60 calories. And the temperature of A ball is 80 degrees Celsius. And the amount of heat energy contained in B ball, that is 200 calories, more than A. And temperature is less than A, that is 60 degrees Celsius. Now the question is, what will be the direction of flow of heat energy? As we know that where the temperature is the determinant of the flow of heat energy. Where the temperature is more, from that region, heat will pass in that region where the temperature is less. So heat will pass from this side to this side. Direction of flow of energy will be from A to B. This is not, this doesn't depend on the amount of heat contained in both of, contained in A. It only depends on the temperature. As the temperature is more, the heat is passing from A to B, not B to A. Similarly, I have discussed that electrons are responsible for the passing of current. Electrons are responsible for the passing of current. So, suppose in this ball, there are 1000 number of negative charges or electrons. And in this ball, there are 100 negative charges or electrons. So, number of electrons is more here. So, what will happen? The electron will move from this side to this side, because here there is more number of electrons. When both of them are joined, heat and electrons will pass from this side to this side. So this electronic flow of current. But according to the convention, it is known that current is passing from positive to negative side. As there are less number of negative charges, so there are more number of protons. So the current is passing from positive to negative side. Though this is the actual flow of current from negative to positive, but it is always known that current is passing from positive to negative side. So this is the conventional flow of current. Conventional flow of current. So in the electricity, in a source of electricity such as battery also, there are two terminals, positive and negative, and you will always remember that current is flowing from positive to negative. Though the actual flow of current, that is from negative to positive, it is always seen that the flow of current is from positive to negative. You have to choose. Suppose this is a battery of two terminals, positive and negative. Current is passing from this to this. Conventional flow of current is passing from this to this, but the actual or electronic flow of current from negative to positive. Let's start. What is electric potential? So, when any electric charge, whether it is positive or negative, is kept in a place such that a positive charge is kept in this region, so surrounding this positive charge, an electric field will be generated. An electric field surrounding this positive charge, an electric field will be generated. So, to remove this positive charge from that region, I have to do some work. Suppose I want to remove this positive charge from this electric field, so I have to do some work, and this amount of work done is known as electric potential. As I am doing some work, I am doing also some, I am spending some energy also, and that energy is stored in the charge. So, what is electric potential? The amount of energy I am spending, as well as you can say the amount of energy stored in the charge, that is also electric potential. So, the amount of work done is in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to a point, to a given point in an electric field, is called electric potential. Suppose this is the electric field, and I am I want to place a positive charge from infinity to this particular point. To do this, I have to spend some energy, and this energy will be stored in the charge as electric potential. So, summarizing, I am repeating again, from infinity, if I want to take a positive charge from infinity to a particular point present in an electric field, I have to do some work, and this work done is stored in this charge as energy. This energy is actually the electric potential of that charge. Suppose I am doing W joule of work for bringing Q coulomb of charge from infinity to a point. So, particularly, what is potential? Potential is W by Q, because I am doing the W joule of work to bring Q coulomb charge. So, W joule is needed to bring Q coulomb, Q charge. So, for bringing one charge, W by Q amount of energy is needed. W by Q amount of energy is needed. This energy is actually stored in that charge in the form of electric potential. So, V is the symbol of electric potential. V is equal to W by Q. V is basically W by Q, the amount of charge amount of work done per unit charge is known as potential. Amount of work done per unit charge. So, what is the SI unit of V? SI unit of V. V is unit of work done, that is joule, divided by unit of charge, that is coulomb. So, joule per coulomb is the unit of potential, that is known as volt. that is known as Volt. So there are two units basically, Joule per Coulomb or Volt. You have to learn both because you don't know which is going to come. So electric unit of electric potential, Joule per Coulomb or Volt. So now what is electric current? As we know, current electricity. So what is electric current? Suppose this is a conductor and there are protons and electrons. Protons and also electrons. These are electrons. So we have learned the direction of flow of current from negative to positive, actual direction of flow of current. So electron will move from in this position. Electron will move in a particular direction and generate current. So electron is moving from this side. So what is the number of electrons passing in 1 second? That denotes current. So what is current basically? Suppose Q amount of charge is flowing through this conductor in T second. Q amount of charge is passing in T second. So in 1 second, what is the amount of charge is passing? Q amount of charge is passing in T second. Number of charge Q is passing. So in 1 second, that is basically by unitary method, Q by T amount of charge is passing. So this Q by T is equal to I. I means the symbol of current is I. So I is equal to Q by T, that means number of charges passing through a conductor in unit time. So what is the definition of electric current? Number of, as this is per unit time, we are considering number of charges per unit time. So basically this is the rate of flow of current. Rate of flow of charge in an electric circuit is called electric current. Because in current electricity, there are so many electric circuits, not only conductor. So in electric circuits, the rate of flow of charge is known as electric current. So what is the SI unit of current? Any physical quantity in current electricity, you have to know the SI units and CGS units also. The SI units of current is coulomb per second or simply ampere. The symbol of ampere is A. Suppose if I write 5 ampere current is passing, that means in unit time through the conductor, 5 amount of current is passing through the conductor. 5 amount of current is passing through the conductor. This is, you have to know again the what is 1 microampere. 1 microampere means 10 to the power minus 6 ampere. 1 milliampere, that means very less amount of current, that is 10 to the power minus 3 ampere. This is all about electric current. We have discussed electric potential, electric current, electric charge, direction of flow of current. So basic terms of related to current electricity are already discussed in this video.
Michael Lobo Shikha Niketan Higher Secondary Government Sponsored Co-ed English Medium School has taken an excellent initiative of teaching and make our students learn day-to-day lessons through audio and video in our YouTube channel. Teachers of all the subjects are working hard to enhance this online classes in amidst of this pandemic situation. It is a request to all the teachers, students and guardians to click the bell icon and subscribe our channel.